Wasps fall into two categories, solitary wasps and social wasps. Social wasps exist in colonies numbering up to several thousand individuals and build nests. Not all of the colony can reproduce, just the wasp queen and male wasps can mate. The majority of the colony is made up of sterile female workers. Females have 2N number of chromosomes and come about from fertilized eggs. Males, in contrast, have a haploid number of chromosomes and develop from an unfertilized egg. Wasps store sperm inside their body and control its release for each individual egg, as it is laid if a female wishes to produce a male egg. She simply lays the egg without fertilizing it, therefore. Wasps have complete voluntary control over the sex of their offspring. It is possible to distinguish between sexes of some wasp species based on the number of divisions on their antennae. Male yellowjacket wasps have 13 divisions per antenna, while females have 12. Males can in some cases be differentiated from females by virtue of having an additional visible segment in the metasoma. The difference between sterile female worker wasps and queens also varies between species, but generally the queen is noticeably larger than both males and other females. All female wasps are potentially capable of becoming a colony's queen, and this process is often determined by which female successfully lays eggs first and begins construction of the nest. Evidence suggests that females compete amongst each other by eating the eggs of other rival females. The queen may, in some cases, simply be the female that can eat the largest volume of eggs, while ensuring that her own eggs survive, often achieved by laying the most. This process theoretically determines the strongest and most reproductively capable female, and selects her as the queen. Wasps do not reproduce via mating flights like bees. Instead, social wasps reproduce between a fertile queen and male wasp. In some cases, queens may be fertilized by the sperm of several males. After successfully mating, the male sperm cells are stored in a tightly packed ball inside the queen. The sperm cells are kept stored in a dormant state until they are needed the following spring. At a certain time of the year, often around autumn, the bulk of the wasp colony dies away, leaving only the young mated queens alive. During this time, they leave the nest and find a suitable area to hibernate for the winter. After emerging from hibernation during early summer, the young queens search for a suitable nesting site. Upon finding an area for their colony, the queen constructs a basic wood fiber nest, roughly the size of a walnut, into which she will begin to lay eggs. The sperm that was stored earlier and kept dormant over winter is now used to fertilize the eggs being laid. The storage of sperm inside the queen allows her to lay a considerable number of fertilized eggs without the need for repeated mating with a male wasp. For this reason, a single queen is capable of building an entire colony by herself. The queen initially raises the first several sets of wasp eggs until enough sterile female workers exist to maintain the offspring, without her assistance. All of the eggs produced at this time are sterile female workers, who will begin to construct a more elaborate nest around their queen as they grow in number. As time progresses, the nest size expands considerably, and now numbers between several hundred and several thousand wasps. Towards the end of the summer, the queen begins to run out of stored sperm to fertilize more eggs. These eggs develop into fertile males and fertile female queens. The male drones then fly out of the nest and find a mate, thus perpetuating the wasp reproductive cycle. In most species of social wasp, the young queens mate in the vicinity of their home nest and do not travel like their male counterparts do. The young queens will then leave the colony to hibernate for the winter once the other worker wasps and founder queen have started to die off. After successfully mating with a young queen, the male drones die off as well. Generally, young queens and drones from the same nest do not mate with each other. This ensures more genetic variation within wasp populations, especially considering that all members of the colony are theoretically the direct genetic descendants of the founder queen and a single male drone. In practice, however, colonies can sometimes consist of the offspring of several male drones. Wasp queens generally, but not always, create new nests each year, probably because the weak construction of most nests render them uninhabitable after the winter. Unlike honeybee queens, wasp queens typically live for only 1 year. Wasps can be differentiated from bees, which have a flattened hind bacitarsus. Social wasps produce nests that are constructed predominantly from paper pulp. The kind of timber used varies from one species to another, and this is what can give many species a nest of distinctive colour. Social wasps also use other types of nesting material that become mixed in with the nest, and it is common to find nests located near to plastic pool or trampoline covers, incorporating distinct bands of colour that reflect the inclusion of these materials that have simply been chewed up and mixed with wood fibres to give a unique look to the nest. Each species of social wasp appears to favour its own specific range of nesting sites. Unlike bees, wasps generally lack plumose hairs. Generally, wasps are parasites or parasitoids as larvae and feed on nectar only as adults. Many wasps are predatory, using other insects, often paralyzed, as food for their larvae. In parasitic species, the first meals are almost always derived from the host, in which the larvae grow. Several types of social wasps are omnivorous, feeding on a variety of fallen fruit, nectar, and carrion. Some of these social wasps, such as yellow jackets, may scavenge for dead insects to provide for their young. In many social species, the larvae provide sweet secretions that are consumed by adults. Adult male wasps sometimes visit flowers to obtain nectar to feed on, in much the same manner as honeybees. Occasionally, some species, such as yellow jackets and especially hornets, invade honeybee nests and steal honey. While the vast majority of wasps play no role in pollination, a few species can effectively transport pollen and therefore contribute for the pollination of several plant species. Being potential or even efficient pollinators, in a few cases such as figs pollinated by fig wasps, they are the only pollinators, and thus they are crucial to the survival of their host plants.